You think it's a drill, you don't think it's not a drill. So it was a bit of panic in the hotel. A lot of people running out. We're at the outrigger Waikiki. A lot of people dashed out of the restaurant into the street. There was a few people upset.
People are in a panic. They're running out of the hotel and people have been told to stay in the hotel. It's the safest place in the hotel.
A little bit of a panic. Everybody was chilling at first. And then next thing you know, just everybody's phones went off one time. And everybody's like chaos. Dogs booked it. They left the beach. My workers left me. He was shaking his hand like, oh. They're so scared.
Well, there was no one on the streets after like a couple minutes. Everyone like left. They all ran into the buildings and stuff. Oh, thank God. You're calling all your parents, telling them you love them. Oh my God.
I saw a few tears out here this morning, but for the most part, people look more just like dazed, kind of wandering around what to do. Because it said to take shelter, but what are you going to do in Honolulu to take shelter?
Started talking to some other hotel people. Started seeing people scrambling all over, leaving their hotel posts and stuff. Called my managers. I went into a hotel, sat around, waited for a bit. A lot of people were crying and trying to get on the phone and call people. All we did was just sit and wait a little bit. It scared a whole lot of people in Hawaii.
We've just heard that there's a missile heading to Hawaii. And I turn to my husband and I go, there's a missile heading to Hawaii? And he goes, what? So all of a sudden, then next thing is the manager of the hotel comes on and the manager is saying that everybody's to stay into their room. There's been an alert, and as soon as they have more information, they'll let us know. So for the next 10, 15 minutes, we're all on tender hooks, not knowing what's going on, and then we get the all clear and that it's just been a false alarm. I'm texting my daughter at home saying, I love you. If I die, I love you. Freakiest thing that's ever happened to me in my whole life. I never want to have this happen again.
It made me think that maybe Hawaii emergency services either got hacked or they're pretty incompetent and probably not going to be very good for tourism in the state.
I don't think anybody's thinking about that. There's more thinking about families because phones got shut off. There was such a surge. I couldn't use no phone to even call anyone.
People were running around, driving 100 miles an hour. People were yelling at each other to get off the side of the road to seek shelter. And we didn't know, nobody knew what was going on. And I was checking the internet at the same time. CNN had nothing on it. So everybody was worried and in a complete panic. There has to be a better way of finding out and going somewhere for information. And because everybody was asking each other and nobody knew any answers. That's aggravating with somebody who lives here and works here and goes to school here. And something has to be done to ensure safety and somewhere you could go online to check out things like this. So people aren't running red lights and people aren't going crazy in the streets and you know what's going on.